मैम
सर प्रिंसिपल सर
ओके ओके मैम
हेलो सर प्रिंसिपल सर सर प्रिंसिपल सर हेलो सर प्रिंसिपल सर सर प्रिंसिपल सर दीपा
मैम करस्पॉन्डेंट सरों उल्ल जॉइन मनी जाऊंगी
सर वेलकम यू सर गुड
वेलकम हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग मैम
मॉर्निंग सर
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम मैम ब्रोकर ஆரம்பிக்கலாங்களா மணி பார்த்தாச்சுங்க
ஆரம்பிக்கலாம் சார் பிரின்சிபல் சார் கால் பண்றாங்க
சரி சரிங்க லிங்க் பண்ணுங்க லிங்க்
ஓகே
ஓகேங்க
ஐ திங்க் மேம்
எஸ் மேம்
நான் கரெக்ட்டா ஜாயின்
மேம் நான் ஜாயின் பண்ணிட்டேங்க இவர சீஃப் கெஸ்ட் உள்ள வந்தாருங்களா வெல்கம்
சார் உள்ள இருக்காரு மார்னிங் சார்
சரி சரி குட் மார்னிங் குட் மார்னிங் சார் மேம் பிரின்சிபல் சார் மட்டும் பார்த்தாச்சுங்க
சார் ஆரம்பிக்கலாம் சார் பிரின்சிபல் சார் கால் பண்றாங்க
சரி சரி லிங்க் பண்ணுங்க
மேடம்
பிரின்சிபல் சார்
நான் உள்ள தான் இருக்கறேங்க நீங்க ப்ரொசீட் பண்ணிருங்க
ஓகேங்க சார் ஓகேங்க சார்
அந்த அஜெண்டா அப்படியே நீங்க இது பண்ணிருங்க சார் அப்படியே வழக்கமா நீங்க வெல்கம் பண்ணிட்டு சார் அடுத்து நானு அது அப்படியே அப்படியே பண்ணிட்டு
சார் உள்ள இருக்காரு மார்னிங் சார்
சரி சரி குட் மார்னிங் குட் மார்னிங் சார் மேம் பிரின்சிபல் சார் மட்டும் பார்த்தாச்சுங்க
ஆரம்பிக்கலாம் சார் பிரின்சிபல் சார் கால் பண்றாங்க
சரி வேண்டாம் வேண்டாம் انا கால் பண்ண வேண்டாம் நான் வந்து ஆல்ரெடி ஐ மீன் தி
பிரின்சிபல் சார்
நான் உள்ள தான் இருக்கறேன் மேடம் ரிசீவ் பண்ணி
ஓகேங்க சார் ஓகேங்க சார்
அஜெண்டா ப்ரோசீட் பண்ணிருங்க ஆரம்பிங்க ஆரம்பிங்க வெல்கம் பண்ணிட்டு சார் அடுத்து நானு அது அப்படியே அப்படியே பண்ணி சீஃப் கெஸ்ட் ரைட்
சார் உள்ள இருக்காரு மார்னிங் சார்
சரி சரி குட் மார்னிங் மேம் பிரின்சிபல் சார் மட்டும்
இல்ல மேடம் நான் உள்ள தான் இருக்கறேன் நீங்க ஆரம்பிச்சிருங்க ஆல்ரெடி ஐ மீன் தி
பிரின்சிபல் சார்
சொல்லுங்க மேடம் ரிசீவ் பண்ணி
ஓகே
சொல்லுங்க மேடம் அஜெண்டா ப்ரோசீட் பண்ணிருங்க ஆரம்பிங்க ஆரம்பிங்க
எஸ் வி ஆர் ப்ரோசீடிங் சார் a warm good morning to all
ரைட்
a warm good morning to all I feel much delighted to have you all today for the inaugural function of KSC funding developmental activities for the academic year 2020-21. Prayer is an opportunity to spend time and communicate with God. That's so let us all raise for the prayer song to get the blessings from the Almighty. Morning to all. Now I invite the children for the prayer song. Morning to all. I feel much delighted to have you all today for the inaugural function of KSC funding developmental activities for the academic year 2020-21. Prayer is an opportunity to spend time and communicate with God. That's so let us all raise for the prayer song.
सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कमरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धे भवतु मे सदा
कम्युनिकेट विद गॉड दैट्स सो लेट अस ऑल रेज फॉर द प्रेयर
सॉन्ग सर्वगायेषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कमरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धे भवतु मे सदा
थैंक यू चिल्ड्रन
गुरु मे देव
A warm and sincere welcome gives a sense of caring and makes people feel comfortable. Now, I invite Dr. S. Nagarajan, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Mathematics, to welcome the gathering.
Happy morning to one and all. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to the inaugural function of KAC Funding Development Cell activities for the year 2020 and 2021 today. First and foremost, I wholeheartedly welcome our honorable correspondent, Sri K. Palanichami Avargal, for his august presence through joining in this inaugural function. I welcome you, sir. I would like to extend my warm welcome to our beloved principal, Dr. N. Raman, who is acting as a catalyst for all our best activities. I welcome you, sir. I feel honored to welcome our chief guest of today, Dr. T. Velmurugan, Associate Professor and Head, Department of BCA, DG Vaishnava College, Autonomous Chennai, who accepted our invitation for giving the inaugural address and going to give webinar on the topic Effective Writing Strategies of Academic Articles for Premier Journals. I welcome you, sir. I extend my heartfelt welcome to our FDC coordinator, Dr. J. Gayatri Madam, Associate Professor, Department of PG Computer Science, for this function. I welcome you, ma'am. I am very much delighted to welcome all our department coordinators of FDC of our college, organizers of this inaugural function, heads of various departments, faculties, and research scholars. I welcome you all. I hope you have an engaging and enriching session ahead. I welcome you all once again for this inaugural function. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Milestone is a way to observe, measure, and monitor the progress or performance of activities. They can also serve as a proof for explaining and reporting the status of the progress. Planning and scheduling is a complicated part of an activity. Planning helps in completing all the small tasks that must be carried out in order to accomplish the goals. Now, I invite Dr. J. Gayatri Devi Ma'am, convener of KAC Funding Development Cell and also the backbone for all the activities of the cell, to present about the milestones of the cell and also to give the future plan for the year 2021. Ma'am?
Good morning to one and all present over here, respected correspondent, our respected principal, and FDC members, and all the participants. Here, I'm here today to present the funding development cell milestones and future plan. This is a cell which comprised of 21 members, starting from me, Dr. Nagarajan, Dr. C. Deepa, Dr. V. G. Sumathi, Dr. G. Manju, Dr. M. Tangam, Dr. R. Rupa, Dr. N. Sangeeta, Dr. K. Radhika, Ms. M. S. Kogila, Ms. Kritika, Ms. Dr. Jayanti, Ms. Hemalata, Ms. C. Vidya, Dr. P. Dinagaran, Mr. Satish Kumar, Mr. Nallappan, Dr. Sankar, Ms. Kanchana, R. Chitra, and Annadurai sir, librarian. So we are the members of this funding development cell. Here some of the work we have carried out in the past 2 years. We have conducted the national level workshop on the title of Planning and Writing Successful Grant Proposals in the Science, Arts and Humanities. Actually, the session was presented by Dr. Vijay Kumar from Erode Arts and Science College and Dr. Rajendran from PhD College of Arts and Science, and Dr. Ponmurugan from Bharathiyar University. They have presented how to write the good proposals and where to submit the proposals and how to carry out these plans. So this was the first program which was carried out in this cell. Then regularly we are doing the skill development activities like calling the explaining the proposals when they are calling, then how to avoid the plagiarism, and tips for getting the fundings and publications of the research papers in the high indexed peer journals. Then overview of the funding project proposals like STRIDE and all, we were doing regularly. Then in the national seminar we have conducted at the December, Dr. Dharmaraj participated as the resource person, and he explained about how to write the academic research papers and how to publish them, them in the book chapters. And in the session 2, in the open educational resource was explained by Dr. J. Gayatri Devi, by myself. And in the we were conducted the survey, our team conducted a survey at Gundri about the awareness and access of health welfare schemes. This is an extended process of the STRIDE project, what we have applied in September 2009. Our team went there and we have done the survey, and we have conducted the regular meetings to at the time of the social pandemic period. Regular weekly meeting was conducted in the on Thursdays. First we were used the WhatsApp, and then we move on to Hangouts, and we have used Zoom, Zmeet, WebEx online platforms to conduct all the meetings to come across the regular barriers. So we have used the online platforms, and we have regularly conduct the meetings to enhance our research activities. So we have conducted one more survey in the KASE students activities. This direction was given by MHRD. There was a request to survey the mentality of the students during the pandemic. This was carried out by our team as the instruction by our principal, and we have got 4,200 responses with the help of our Swayam MOOC coordinators, and we have submitted the report to our principal for this survey. And this is the survey form what we have created, and throughout the survey we have collected the data from our students only through this online forms. Then we have on behalf of ourselves we have conducted a webinar series in this pandemic period. 3 days program it was, on 20th, 21st and 22nd of May. In the 21st, Nirmala Devi Singarvelu from USA, she was talking about the business intelligence, real process, what they are doing in the industry. And myself, Dr. J. Gayatri, was discussing about the research areas in that business intelligence. And the next day, Dr. Anbumani given the ideas about earn through online translation. And then the next day, Ms. S. Yasmin of the English department professor given a webinar on English as a lingua franca, an overview of research article writing. And the same day I have given one more webinar, open educational resources. So these are our achievements in this pandemic period. And one more great achievement in this pandemic period is facilitation of study on impact of COVID-19 in adjoining villages of Konga Arts and Science College. This task was also assigned by MHRD. It's an optional task, but as per the instruction of our principal, we have carried out 6 villages we have to take, and we have to analyze the reports. But through the online, we have done for 4 villages, and for the remaining 2 villages, we have gone in person and we have collected the data. A team of members have gone with the permission of our principal and the correspondent. We went through this, and we have collected the data, and in time we have submitted the analysis to the MHRD. These are the some glimpses of the survey. So totally what we have attempted so many projects. Totally we have applied for 22 grants. In that in STRIDE 20 members attempted. We are waiting for the results in this regard. Then now the process under data analysis are tribal health awareness survey, which we have conducted. We are doing the data analysis. And on the student survey, COVID-19 impacts, we are doing the data analysis. And village people survey, what we have conducted in this pandemic period, this is also we are under the survey. Then the academic year plan 2020 and 2021, what we are planning is we are preparing the, we are writing the book chapters regarding the COVID-19, what we were discussing in this pandemic period as book chapters, then facilitating the platform for the budding researchers, then workshop on patent filing. Actually, we are publishing the papers, but what I have heard from a webinar is before presenting the publications, we have to go for the patent filing to get the copyright of our work. So we are focusing more on this patent filing. Then in the next one, we are strengthening our publications in the peer-reviewed SSS, CA, Scopus, and SCA indexed journals. Then we are preparing of project proposals to generate the funds from funding agencies regularly. Then the next focus is our consultancy services. This we are mainly concentrating in the, we are going to focus on this one for preparing surveys or for preparing data analysis like this. We are concentrating. This is one of our year plan in this year. So the resources what we have collected. So thank you one and all. I thank our management and our principal for constantly supporting us to do all our activities in this regard, and thank my team also for this regular support. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, ma'am. Our correspondent, Thiru K. Palaniswamy sir, is a source of inspiration and a living example for simplicity. His encouragement and support helps us to move forward with all our activities. Now, I invite our current sponsor to deliver the presidential address.
Kongu Kalaiyarivil Kalluri, hello? Hello?
Hello?
Okay, ma'am. I will proceed.
Okay.
Kongu Arts and Science College, the effective writing strategies of academic articles for பிரிமியர் ஜேர்னல்ஸ் என்கிற தலைப்பில் இன்று சிறப்புரையாற்றி இருக்கின்ற டாக்டர் டி வேலுமணி வேல்முருகன் சார் அவர்களை வருக வருக நம்ம வரவேற்பதில் கொங்கு கலைஞர் கல்லூரி பெருமகிழ்ச்சி அடைகிறது. வெல்கம் அட்ரஸ் செய்து கொடுத்த டாக்டர் எஸ் நாகராஜன் சார் அவர்களுக்கு எனது மனமார்ந்த நன்றிகளை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். இதுவரைக்கும் நம்ம கொங்கு ஆர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் சயின்ஸ் காலேஜில் செஞ்சிருக்கிற ப்ரோக்ராம்ஸ் எல்லாம் காயத்ரி மேடம் எல்லாம் டிஸ்கிரிப்டிவாக எல்லாத்தையும் ஒவ்வொன்றும் எடுத்து சொன்னாங்க. அவங்களுக்கு என்னுடைய வாழ்த்துக்கள். இன்னும் மென்மேலே இந்த டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்டு இந்த எஃப்டிசி செல் வளர்க்கிற தேவைகளை நான் என்னால் முடிஞ்சு சப்போர்ட் செஞ்சு கொடுக்குறேன்னு ரொம்ப பெருசாக செஞ்சு கொடுக்கணும்னு ஆசைப்பட்றோம். ட்ரஸ்ட்லி சொல்லி உங்களுக்கு வேணுங்கிற சப்போர்ட்டையும் செஞ்சு கொடுக்குறோம். நீங்கள் அதுக்கு தகுந்த எல்லா முயற்சிகளையும் போட்டு இன்னும் எவ்வளோ பீக்கில் கொண்டு போய் சேர்த்த முடியுமோ அந்த ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி செஞ்சு கொண்டு போய் கொடுங்க. அதுபோக இதுக்கு உள்ளுக்குள்ளக்கூடிய பார்ட்டிசிபெண்ட்ஸ் உங்களுடைய எஃப்டிசி மெம்பர்ஸ் அத்தனை பேர்த்தையும் பார்க்க வருகிற வரவேற்புல பெருமகிழ்ச்சி கொள்கிறேன். ஏன்னா அதில் நாகராஜன் சார், இவர் நம்ம நல்லப்பன் சார், ராமன் சார் எல்லாத்துக்குமே என்னுடைய மனமார்ந்த பாராட்டுகள். உங்களுடைய பார்ட்டிசிபெண்ட்ஸ், உங்களுடைய மெம்பர்ஸ் அனைவருக்கும் என்னுடைய வாழ்த்துக்கள். இன்னும் இந்த டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்டுக்கு எல்லாரும் ஒரு கை தட்டுனா ஓசை வராது. அதே மாதிரி இந்த 20-22 பேர் இருக்கிறவங்க எல்லாரும் சப்போர்ட்டிவாக இருந்து இந்த டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் டெவலப்மெண்ட் செல்லுக்கு அவங்களோட 100% அவங்களோட எஃபோர்ட்டை கொடுத்து மேலே கொண்டு வரக்குண்டான வளர்ச்சியை அடைய செய்யறதுக்கு என்னுடைய மனமார்ந்த இதை செஞ்சு கொடுங்க. இதை ப்ரோக்ராம் பெருசாக 2-3 நாளாகவே இந்த ப்ரோக்ராமுக்கு உழைச்சிக்கிட்டு இருக்கக்கூடிய டாக்டர்ஸ் தீபா மேம், ஜெயந்தி மேம், காயத்ரி மேம் அவங்களுக்கு என்னுடைய பாராட்டுகள், வாழ்த்துக்கள். ப்ரோக்ராமுக்கு நம்ம பிரின்சிபல் சார் வந்து 2-3 நாளைக்கு முன்னாடி சொல்லி தர மாதிரி ஒரு ப்ரோக்ராம் பண்ணுறாங்க சார். இது நம்ம வருஷம் வருஷம் நல்லா பண்ணுவோம், இந்த வருஷம் இப்படி இந்த கோவிட் பிரச்சனையினால நம்ம இப்படி இதில் பண்ணிக்கலாம்னு சொல்லியிருக்கிறாங்க. இதுக்கும் வந்து டாக்டர் ரமணன் சார் நம்மளுக்கு, ராமன் சார் வந்து 2-3 நாளாகவே நம்மளுக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்ணி இந்த டெவலப்மெண்ட் செயலுக்கு தேவையானதை எல்லாத்தையும் செஞ்சு கொடுத்துருக்கிறாரு. அவர் எல்லாத்தையும் உங்களை ஊக்குவிச்சு நான் மேலே கொண்டு வந்து ஒவ்வொரு ஸ்டேஜ் பை ஸ்டேஜ் உங்களுக்கு கூடையே இருந்து சப்போர்ட்டிவாக பண்ணி கொடுப்பாரு. அதுக்கு அவருக்கு என்னுடைய வாழ்த்துக்களையும் சொல்லிக்கிறேன். அவர் இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் இந்த சப்போர்ட்டிவாக இன்னும் பெருசாக பண்ணி கொடுக்கணும்னு அச்சீவ் பண்ணணும்னு சொல்லி ஆசைப்படுறாரு. அவருக்கும் என்னுடைய வாழ்த்துக்களை சொல்லிக்கிறேன். இவங்க டாக்டர் விஜி சுமதி மேடத்துக்கு என்னுடைய வாழ்த்துக்களை தெரிவிச்சுக்கிறேன். இந்த ப்ரோக்ராம் நல்லபடியும் சக்ஸஸாக முடிச்சு கொடுக்கறதுக்கு டாக்டர் வேல்முருகன் சார் அவர்கள் அடுத்த ப்ரோக்ராம் கண்டக்ட் பண்ணி சொல்லி என்னுடைய இதை தெரிவிச்சு சொல்கிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
Thank you sir for your words of appreciation and encouragement.
Thank you ma'am. Thank you.
Our principal, Dr. N. Raman sir, is a diamond person who is behind all our planning and execution of the activities of our cell. His guidance has made us to move in the right direction and always ahead of others. Now, I invite our principal to facilitate the gathering.
Madam, good morning. கேக்குதுங்களா?
Good morning, sir.
Are you able to hear?
Yes, sir.
Good morning. Yes, sir. Right. Thank you. Good morning to all. At the outset, I extend a cordial welcome to our correspondent, sir. Guest, Dr. T. Velmurugan, sir. Fund Development Cell Coordinator, Dr. Gayathri, and her associates and other learning members for this inaugural function. See, actually, we wanted to have or to complete PhD. After completion of the PhD, I hope that our one purpose of the mission will complete. We are a doctorate. That will not serve the purpose in your academic stream. So the other part of that, obtaining the doctorate is you have to go for publishing the worthwhile articles in your domain area. The second part is wherever it is possible, you have to tap the resources of the various funding agencies to carry out your projects. So for that, somebody should guide, somebody should show the direction. I hope that this funding development cell is taking the efforts to show the path, to show how to work, to show they are taking the hand and they are walking along with you to achieve a target in all that the aspects. And recently, the UGC has sent the circular to all the colleges stating that try to conduct a survey submit the report. What is the status of the students during the COVID-19? This is the one part. We have conducted, with our, all the students, 4,200 students has participated in the survey. And the second issue, the UGC has sent a circular as to conduct COVID-18 and as well as 19. In 19-18, how was the situation? How it was controlled by the people in those days? And we want to learn things from the experiences from the past events. So we wanted to conduct such a survey also. I think that the fund development cell members, with their enormous efforts, they submitted a well beautiful and as well as worthwhile report to the UGC. I hope that it will be much useful for the higher authorities also, higher learning institutions also. Likewise, I appeal all the members of the cell, try to utilize the facilities available in the campus, which are all provided by the management, as said by our correspondent. Now we are in the 27th year of our inception, right from the inception. Now we are in the 27th year. We have to take the institution to the sum of the greater heights. Always the Kungu is the best. Likewise, even the research also in this region, the Kungu region, when anybody, they wanted to have a kind of sources to access, sources to utilize it, they should come to the Kungu Arts to utilize the services of our, the facilities available in the campus. So I congratulate Dr. Gayathri and her team and all other members for this making a wonderful inaugural session. It's a live session joined the Zoom right from the beginning. And they have presented the whole report, what has happened in 2019-20 and how it was useful for that our students and as well as the faculty members. I wish the fund development cell to go still for another milestone to achieve in their the career path and as well as in their other activities also. Once again, I thank for your opportunities given to me. And on behalf of the management, on behalf of the funding development cell, I extend a cordial welcome to our guest, Dr. T. Velmurugan, sir. And if it is a kind of the face-to-face contact program, still we can have more things to display it. It is in a social media. So we have been asked to restrict it our activities also. thank you for the opportunities given to me. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for all your kind words. And definitely, we'll assure that Funding Development Cell will do all the required things. Thank you, sir. Our chief guest is a very renowned person in India. Today, he is here to deliver the inaugural address and talk on effective writing strategies of academic articles for peer-reviewed journals. Now, I invite Dr. Sumati Ma'am to introduce our chief guest.
Good morning, all. I'm very much happy to introduce Dr. T. Velmurugan, Associate Professor in the PG and Research Department of Computer Science and Applications. Also, he is a head of the Department of Computer Science and Applications, DG Vaishnava College, Chennai. Started his teaching career in the year 1993 and continues the academic journey till date. In this 27 years of teaching experiences, his contribution towards research community is remarkable. He has published more than 75 articles in journals indexed in the Web of Science and in Scopus, acted as a chairperson in the international conferences held in various countries like Thailand, China, Singapore, Malaysia, Italy, and UAE. Also invited as a resource person for more than 36 conferences and symposium at the state and national levels. He is an editorial board member of many international journals and also reviewer in many peer-reviewed journals like Elsevier, Springer, ISO, Press Journals, etc. Further, he is a visiting faculty for the MPhil courses for various universities throughout India. He has hosted a lot of programs in Doordarshan about recent topics in information technology. So like this, his contribution runs into pages. Thank you for giving an opportunity to introduce such a rich and experienced research personality. Thank you for the opportunity. Now the session is open to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Okay. Can I share my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes. A little bit only volume, please.
Good morning, one and all present here. I welcome you all for this webinar on the effective writing strategies of research articles or academic articles for premier journals, actually, which is organized by the Kongu Arts and Science College, Erode. Before starting the discussion, first I would like to thank for having inviting me as a resource person for this webinar. Now, it's my privilege to thank the correspondent, Mr. Thiru K. Panichami, Kongu Arts and Science College, and the principal, Dr. N. Raman, Kongu Arts and Science College, and the coordinators of this cell, Funding Development Cell, Gayatri Madam, and Nagarajan sir, and Sumati madam, and going to say a word of thanks, Dr. Jayanti, and other people, Dr. Deepa, and those who are involved in this process. Thank you very much for inviting me as a research person for this program. Thank you. Now, within this small kinds of information, sir, we have to discuss what are the things we want to discuss in this session. Technical writing, how we can be able to write technically the research articles, sir. What are the tips for writing technical articles, sir. What are the types of research articles, sir, manuscripts are available, and what is the format for writing the research paper, and how a research scientific research paper can be written by you. Now, how to prepare the references and the citing references, how to cite your references, cite the sum of the references in your text, in your research paper. Now, what are the key points of preparing a scientific research article and how to write a project proposal for funding agencies. Then little bit about intellectual property rights, IPR. Then finally, we discuss about what is Scopus indexed journals, what are Web of Science journals, how to find out the Scopus indexed journals and the Web of Science journals. So finally, we conclude the session. This is the outline of this program. Now, first we have to understand what is the base for a higher education. The base for a higher education is research and publication. Whenever the research and publication are improved, increased by means of producing the research articles through their research people, so those who are involved in a particular organization, which will improve the name of the institution always. So the base for any kind of higher education must include the publication of research articles in their institutional names. So the research and the publication is the base of higher educational setup nowadays. Therefore, we have to increase our knowledge how to produce the research article, how to write the research article, how to publish the research article, and go to like that. So this is the very simple method. Then now we have to discuss how we can able to produce some kind of research articles. Mostly my topic is based on the scientific oriented research article. Somewhat it is equal to all the arts, humanities and other areas, social sciences. For all these topics it is included. The topic discussed here is included. Okay. Now what is called as technical writing articles? What are the technical articles? What are the research articles are available? Manuscripts are available, sir. One is report writing. The another one is manuscripts or article, or research article or research paper. Then thesis. There are three kinds of articles. There are three kinds of writing. Technical writing is available in any kind of higher education institutions. Okay. Whether it is a college or whether it is a research-oriented institutions, some kind of research-oriented institutions alone are affiliated through some universities that are also used in this. And universities and deemed university and other kind of universities. For all these kinds of information, what we require, there are three kinds of technical writing. One is report writing and another one is preparation of manuscripts, research article and research paper. Finally, the thesis. The thesis is fully depends on your doctoral degree oriented. Okay. Now, first we want to understand what is the difference between the thesis and the research article. A thesis is a long report on a particular topic. A long report. You have to choose a particular topic, write about a lengthy essay based on your particular simple, a short topic. That is the thesis. But a research article is a short report on a broad topic. So we can prepare a research manuscript based on a broad topic, but a short information, a short report you have to prepare. The short report may be between minimum 6 pages to a maximum 30 pages or 20 pages and go like this, like that. Depends on the journal that you want to produce, that you want to publish. Now, you have to understand what is the difference between the thesis and the synopsis. Many of you are not known very well how to prepare the thesis. What is the difference between the synopsis and the thesis? Now, you assume you are sitting in a hill, in a mountain, seeing a village which is available in the base of a hill is very easy. The village is a synopsis. Suppose if you sit in the village seeing the hill, then it will shown a big stones, big informations, big view. So the hill is called as a thesis. So synopsis and the thesis are simply, we can identify like that. Now, what is a thesis? A thesis is an argument. The argument with the evidence to prove the usefulness of an user's idea, researcher's idea, your idea. So thesis is an argument. You have to give some argument with your evidence in order to prove your evidence, in order to prove your hypothesis, in order to state your conclusion. You want to prove some evidences. You want to prove some evidences in your thesis. So the thesis is actually provided by means of your own idea, by means of your research categories, by means of your subject-oriented information, by means of your research-oriented contribution, you can provide some text, and not only text, also which includes monographs, figures, tables, chart, and results-oriented information. Everything is given in a thesis. Therefore, a thesis is a well-prepared document. You want to produce a well-prepared document. That's why we are reading research methodology in your MPhil course or in your PhD course. In a doctoral degree or in your dissertation, that is MPhil course, you must prepare, you must study well about the research methodology. What methodology is used for preparation of the document? That's why we require some kind of methodology in order to prepare your document. Therefore, a thesis is a well-prepared document which contains the details of the research carried out by you. And also the well-prepared document contains the findings of your research. Your innovative idea, your research contribution must be available in your thesis as a conclusion. So this is called as a thesis. It has a thesis statement. Always, yes, thesis has a thesis statement. It is a one sentence statement. A thesis statement, a heading of the thesis must be a one sentence statement, which sums up their entire research work. The entire research work must be summed up in your, which shows your entire thesis, your entire work. That is your title of the thesis. Okay. So the thesis statement is formulated as a hypothesis. Your thesis statement itself contains some conditions. Your thesis statement itself having some ideas, that is having some methodologies. Everything must include in the thesis. Okay. Now, what is the format for writing a thesis? First, you have to give title of the thesis. Then first page, in the first page. Then declaration part. Then certificate from your supervisor. Then acknowledgement you can use, you can thank to any people, sir. Then table of contents. After the acknowledgement, a table of contents. Then list of figures, list of tables, list of symbols, list of abbreviations. Sometimes in some people's uses, list of tables, list of figures, list of symbols, and list of abbreviations, except the table of contents at the end of the thesis, after the list of publications. So this also possible. Okay. Next, to list of abbreviations, we have to give the abstract. You must understand clearly, there is a lot of difference between the abstract and the synopsis. Some people are not identifying what is the difference between abstract and the synopsis. Synopsis is entirely different from abstract. Okay, abstract must be which you have your limitations to write an abstract in your research article. Okay, only the research article and the research thesis, you must write abstract. But the synopsis is entirely a separate individual document, a unique document that is provided and submitted before submitting your thesis. That is synopsis. Okay. Then after the abstract, it is enough to give the chapters. It is enough to include, enter your chapters, chapters 1, 2, and so on and so on. And then conclusion. Then you have to publish, enter your, that is given your references. Then appendices. In appendices, what are the things you want to include? You can include source code, you can include data set about the data set, you can include your other kind of data collection methods and other people's informations, other sources of collecting the informations, those who are involved in this process, anything else. Then what is list of publications? Your publications which are related to your thesis alone are given in this list of publications. This is the format of a thesis. Now, what are the different kinds of types of article? Research article, review article, survey article. Not an overview. I'm not informed you. Overview is not a research-oriented paper, research-oriented article. So only three kinds of informations are actually called as a article, manuscript, research paper, research article. So what is called as a research article? A research article presents original research by the study's authors. If you are the author of the research article, you have to show your original research contribution in your research article. That is research article. So a research article explores new areas of investigation. The new areas of investigation must include the answer about your hypothesis, answer about your research questions, which is actually proposed when you started. Well, actually, the research hypothesis is set by you before starting the research work. So whatever the hypothesis you prepared for doing your research, everything should be answered by means of your explanation in the research articles. Okay. Now, next one is a review article. So review article, the review article examines previous research in an area of interest on a particular point based on your data set, based on your same kind of existing algorithm. Some people are producing some kind of results using the same data set, using the same algorithm, by using different approach. You are producing another one result in the same topic. So you have to give you an explanation about the review, how your result is differ from others' result in the same base data set, in the same algorithm, same existing algorithm. This is the review article. So for any kind of review article which summarizes the previous research work and identify unanswered questions which are produced from others, okay. So by the people, those who are already published their paper using your data set, using your existing algorithms, you have to compare your produced result with their produced result, review status as a review method, how it is compared, your result is different. This is called as a review article. Then what is called as a survey article? Which explains about some previous research in an area of interest on a particular topic, based on a particular data set, or based on more than one or two algorithmic oriented or subject oriented, particular subject oriented, subject particular specific domain oriented information are surveyed. How many people are carry out their papers using this topic, using this data set, using this method, using this approach? Everything is surveyed. And finally, you have to conclude what is your contribution in the survey article. That is the survey article. I already informed, I have explained what is review article and what is survey article and what is overview. It is a summary of the research work, overview. So some people are doing the publishing their research work based on overview. For example, cryptographic techniques on overview. Overview, it is a notes for taking classes. That is the important point. Then okay, what are the different kinds of presentations nowadays available? Research paper presentation, tutorial presentation, poster presentation, industry track papers presentation, then virtual presentation. So now we are doing virtual presentations. Virtual conferences are going on, then we can do our presentation through online, is called as virtual presentation. So what is research paper presentation? In front of some audience in an auditorium, you have to produce in a conference, area, in a conference room, you have to produce your paper, that is, you have to explain your paper by means of your own words, what is your contribution of your research work, everything is explained clearly, and then they ask some questions, is called as a research paper presentation. Then what is called as a tutorial presentation? Tutorial presentation is mostly carried out for a particular subject. Suppose if you are very well about the complex analysis, if you are very well about statistical methods, then if you are very well about discrete mathematics, then you have to write a two-page abstract about your tutorial presentation and then present in a conference by the way just 10 to 15 minutes presentation, your presentation, but they ask more questions in a particular subject oriented. If you are very well in data mining, they can ask any question based on the subject, that is tutorial presentation. So based on a particular subject, not a particular topic. So based on the particular subject, they ask some questions. This is called as a tutorial presentation. The question and answer session mostly half an hour, minimum 20 minutes, maximum 30 minutes, or depends on the conference type. Okay, then what is called as poster presentation? Your second quality of papers are presented in a conference by means of poster. You have to prepare some slides and printed it into and post it into the banner, that is in a wall and everything, they are provided. Then you got to explain in front of the wall, in front of the poster, you got to explain your research contribution. They can ask, anybody can ask. More people are asking the same questions, you can explain. This is the concept of the poster presentation. Okay. Now, how to write a research paper? Your scientific experiment will never complete, will not complete until the results have been published and understood by others. Your results must be understood by others. Your result must be published by means of some journals, by means of some publishing mediums. So your published results only shown your research contribution. Otherwise, your experiment is not fulfilled. Your experiment is not completed. Okay. Then a scientific paper is written and a published report describing original research results. So your published paper, your scientific paper, not only the scientific paper, also any kind of paper, whether it is a semantic oriented, that is arts and humanities oriented, or social science oriented, literature oriented, linguistic oriented, language oriented, any kind of papers must be published through by means of a publishing medium. Then only your identified results are understand, and then only your identified results are captured by many people, reached to many people. So this is the for that purpose alone we want to write a research paper. So what is the purpose of writing research paper? The purpose of writing scientific writing is to communicate new scientific findings. So scientific writing must use proper English, and which gives the sense in the fewest short words. You have to use a proper English, and so it gives some clear idea. The written in a simple manner, in a well-ordered communication, in a well-ordered method, in order to transmit your scientific findings, your research-oriented contribution should be explored by means of some special kind of your own technique is called as is the main concept of using this publicity, using this publication concept. For that purpose, we able to write research article. What are the areas of research article? Arts and humanities, social sciences, physical sciences, life sciences, applied sciences. These things are, I think, a little bit in speed, right? Because I have more slide, please accept it. Now, what is the format for writing the, how we are entering into, how to write the research article? There is a format, IMRAD format. Introduction, method, results, and discussion is the IMRAD format. What is introduction? What question was studied? What is method? How was the problem studied? What is the result? What are your findings? And what is discussion? What is the impact of your findings, your results? The impact of your results are explained by means of discussion. This is the most accepted format. I am not produced these informations by own manner. This is actually suggested by Springer journals, Springer and elsewhere journals. I am copy this method informations through Springer only. Okay, I will show where these informations are available in Springer website. I will show later. Okay, what? How to organize a scientific paper in particular? The most common method for producing the scientific paper is IMRAD, already I know. Methods and results section are combined into one section that is called as the experimental section. Methods and results are combined into one that is called as experimental section. Then the results and the discussion sections are combined into one place that is results and discussion section. Okay, so this is the organization of your scientific paper. Not only the scientific paper, also for all kinds of papers, also for all categories of areas. Okay. Now, what are the essential parts of your scientific paper? Title, abstract, introduction, materials, methods, results, discussion, summary, acknowledgement, and references. This is the essential part of your scientific paper. If it is possible to include all these topics, sections in your research article, it's not possible. Some kind of research article include only some of the methods. That is, title, abstract, introduction must available. Okay. And the discussion results may be combined. Materials and the methods may be combined. The acknowledgement sometimes in many people they are never given the acknowledgement. Finally, references and the conclusion. So this is the essential part. But in which one is required format? Only the required format of any kind of research papers is abstract, introduction, materials and methods, results and discussion, or results and discussion separately. then conclusions, then references. This is the format for writing the research article. Okay. Now, what is called as abstract? What is introduction? What is materials and methods? Everything should be clearly explained in the next slides. Now, how to create a title? How to create a title? A good title is defined as the fewest possible words that adequately describe your content of the paper. Suppose if you type your title in the Google search engine, your paper must appear in first, then only your title is appropriate. Otherwise, your title is not suitable. For any kind of research article, if you type your title in the Google search engine, Google Scholar.com, Scholar.google.com, because which is Scholar.google.com only contains the research article-oriented information. The Google content contains many kind of research article, no problem. So any kind of, not only the research article, any information which is available in the Google search engine. So, but if you type your title, definitely your paper must appear in the first page and the first line itself. Then only your title should be appropriate. So that is, the title is extremely important and must be chosen with great care, as it will be read by thousands, and whereas few will read the entire paper. So if 1,000 people are reading your title, it should be clear. Whenever the first time your title is read by one people, then easily understand what is inside available, what is the concept, what is available in the paper. Everything should be exactly identified. Then what is the purpose of giving an appropriate title? The appropriate title should enable your research article by means of indexing and abstracting the paper. Most of the journals are having indexing and abstracting services. What is indexing and abstracting services? We will discuss later. Okay. Indexing and abstracting services here, those journals are having, then your title must give the indexing services. Your title must independently shown in any kind of abstracting and indexing service oriented journal articles. So an improper titled paper will get lost and will never be read. Improper title will never be read by many people. So what is the method for preparation of the title? The title should be neither be too short nor too long. It should be within a sentence. It should be a maximum two sentences. One sentence, two lines. So not too short nor too long. That is the also within the concept of your topic, and also some have meaningful information. The meaningless title should not accepted by me. You don't use waste words, studies on, investigations on, and the, etc. These are all understand. These are all waste words. These words are not used. The syntax, the word order must be careful. The syntax, which word appear first, which word appear second, these things are already very, very important point. Then it should contain the keywords that reflect the contents of the paper. Yeah, whatever you produced in the keywords section, at least one of the keyword or two of the keyword must available in the title. That is the main point. Then you should be meaningful and not general. General titles are not accepted, are not referred by many people. It should be concise, specific and informative. Then you should capture the fundamental nature of the experiments and the findings. Whatever the fundamental nature of the experiment, your experiment oriented information, your findings, research contribution oriented information must reflect in your title. Okay. How to prepare the title? You have to list the most important keywords. Using your keyword, you can prepare a title. Think of a title that contains these keywords. The title could state the conclusion of the paper also. We can assume what is the conclusion, how, in what manner the manuscript is prepared and written. They should identify easily whenever they read your title. So the title never contains abbreviations, chemical formulas. Many people are following this information. The title never contains abbreviations. Most of the people, myself, I am also include some abbreviations in my papers. So, which is never we use abbreviations, chemical formulas, priority names, jargons, nicknames, everything should not available in order to make a title. So, think and rethink about your title before submitting the paper. Very careful to grammatical errors due to faulty word order. Then you have to avoid the word using. But is it possible? Is it possible? No, it is not possible. Always 80 to 90% of people nowadays we are using the word using. That is important. The effective title should be convey the main topics of the study, which highlight the importance of the research. Be concise, attract readers. The title should be attraction. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. This is my title. This is my first Scopus indexed information. I am given the link itself. Computational complexity between k-means and k-modified clustering algorithm for normal and uniform distributions of data points. This is the title. Now you can understand computational complexity means runtime, execution-oriented information. Okay. What are the methods applied? K-means and k-modified clustering. What type of algorithm these are? Clustering algorithm. What is the data set used? Normal and uniform distributions of data points are used as a data set. Therefore, the computational complexity gives the comparative study between k-means and k-modified algorithm based on the execution time. This is simple. So, a very simple manner, you can give the title. I am the editorial board member of the Journal of Computer Science, which is Scopus Index Journal. Suppose if anybody want to publish papers in Journal of Computer Science, thesaibub.com. You got to note that thesaibub.com. I am the editorial board member. I am the first editorial board member in this journal in India. Okay, now you can publish, but $600 they require. $600 they require. I will give you tips for publishing your article. How to get a discount to publish your papers after accepting your article. I will give you, but which is not discussed in this open forum. You can call me, I will explain. Okay, now other point, how we can include your author name. There are multiple authors are available, but the two author, three authors are available means only the first author is the original author. The second authors are co-authors and other people. So, who is the owner of the paper? The first author is the owner of the paper. Many of the peoples are putting their guide name in their research article. So you are not the author of your research article. Your guide is the author of your research article. So you please mostly avoid your guide name first in your research article. Only your name must appear in front of the first place of your author's identification. Okay, so this is the point. Now, other affiliation is another kind. The other affiliation, university name or institution name, which enables you in order to produce more impact for your institution. So, in order to produce the impact of your, institution, in order to visualize, publish your institution name, you must use the institution affiliation at the end of, that is in the second line of your other. What is the correct method for the giving the other name and other thing? You will that T. Well, Murugan, assistant professor, D.V. Vaishnava College, this thing. Now, this is one method. This is another method. First other information, second other informations are available. Okay. Now, which one is incorrect method? One star, two star, and one has one star. The star has, these things are not accepted. Only this kind of one and two. Okay. One and two and other things. This star and has are not accepted. Okay. Now, what is the abstract preparation? Next point, we want to go to discuss about the abstract preparation. A summary of the content of the journal manuscript. So, a shortcut method that you want to discuss about your research article is called as abstract. By using, suppose your abstract have 10 sentences. First two sentences about your major domain of your research. That is, suppose if you are very well about cryptographic methods, about cryptography, In cryptography, there are some security-oriented algorithms, about security-oriented algorithm, two sentences. And using what kind of data set, what data set used in your research, about your data set, two sentences. And about your result you want to produce, don't say this kind of result is produced in your abstract. This kind of result going to be produced in your research, that like a manner you have to produce. Two sentences about your data set, then two sentences about your results, and two sentences about your how to produce the results, how you can conclude this data set, using this data set, using this algorithmic approach, some comparison study is carried out and concluded in this research work, like you can explain, give in the abstract. This is the main point of preparation of the abstract. Okay. A guide to the most important parts of your manuscript written content. Most of the reviewers are reading only your abstract and conclusion. So if your abstract is very well clearly stated, then exactly the reviewers are accepted your article. Okay, sometimes the only part of your manuscript, that is I explained. Okay, many readers will read only your abstract and your conclusion. So therefore, it has to be able to stand alone. Your abstract should be standalone. Individual information. So in order to read out your entire article, it is enough to read only the abstract. The people's must understand what is available in your research article, must be exactly identified. Okay. How to prepare the abstract? You should provide a brief summary of each of the main sections of the paper. I already explained. State the principal objective and the scope of the investigation. Describe the methods. Summarize the results. State the principal conclusions. These four things, that is, include the data sets. One more point is missing in this slide. Okay. So, major domain topic is discussed within two lines, three lines, and describe the methods, what method, what data set, and what about the results, and what is your, how you conclude. These things are discussed. Okay. So, the abstract must be between 150 to 300 words. Below 150 words, if you prepare your abstract, I never accept. I am the editorial board member and the review board member in most of the more than 50 journals. I am the reviewer. Okay, only in Springer, you know very well, more than 2000 journals are available in Springer. More than 2000 journals are available in Springer and elsewhere. I am the reviewer board member for more than 20-25 journals in each category. So everything must be very carefully listened by the reviewers, because in elsewhere and Springer, minimum 3 people are reviewing your articles. Okay, maximum 6 people are reviewing your articles. Therefore, your abstract must be below 150. They will never accept your thesis. So if your abstract contains more than 300 words, this also too long, too high, too large. So I already explained, you must use between 150 to 300 words in your abstract. Already I am explained what is the how to prepare the abstract. Introduction, that is general topic, methods, hypothesis, conditions, results, and the conclusions. These things must include in the abstract. So it should not exceed 300 words written in one paragraph. No two paragraphs are available. Only your entire thesis, entire research article must be written by using the past tense, not present tense and future tense. You have to use this research paper. Only past tense only you have to use the research article. Okay. So the past tense only you must use in your research article, also in your thesis. Long words should not be used. Abbreviations are abbreviated first time whenever it is appear in the abstract itself. Okay, it should not cite any references. The abstract will never cite any references. We cannot include any references in your abstract. You should never contain any information about conclusion that is not stated in the paper. Whatever you want to produce as a conclusion, as a research oriented contribution, which never give previously in your abstract. Okay, so must be accurate with respect to figures and quoted in the main text. Must be accurate. Your abstract must state about your text which is available, which is written in the body of your research article. Okay, what is the sample of that? Detection of brain tumor by particle form optimization using image segmentation. Using is available. It is not possible to avoid. For here, background and objectives, two sentences. Methods and statistical methods, two or three sentences. Findings and the data set, about data sets are the three or four sentences. Applications and improvements are future scope of the research, not future scope. What is the conclusion you want to apply here? These things are available. Now, I already informed that all these informations are actually taken from this Springer website. If you press this link, definitely you may get the all information that already we discussed what is available. Okay, now how to prepare the keywords. Keywords are playing a very important role in the research, in your research article, because now whatever the keywords you are given in your research article, which reflect the search engine, which reflects the search engine search bar. Okay, any kind of search engine search bar. Many kind of search engines nowadays, like altavista.com, not only Google. Many kind of search engines are available. Your keywords must be available, reflect in title, then your keywords are very, very important. So keywords are the tool to help indexers and search engines find relevant papers. Okay. So database search engines can find your journal manuscript using your keyword, some readers are simply typing peer-to-peer network, like keywords in your article have peer-to-peer network, then definitely your paper will considered in front of the search categories. Okay, so this will increase the number of people reading your manuscript, likely lead to more citations. Okay, effective keywords must be chosen carefully, represent the content of your manuscript. Your content of the manuscript, the keywords must represent. Okay, be specific to your field. And sub-field. Be specific. A particular specific oriented field informations are entered as in the place of keyword. Then keywords must be a maximum of 5, minimum of 3. Some people are given 1 or 2 keywords, it is not accepted. Some people are given more than 8-7 keywords, this is not accepted. In the keyword itself, they are not given the nicknames, abbreviations, jargons, everything. So examples of keyword, the title of the manuscript is Performance Analysis of AODV and DSR Routing Protocols and Mobile Hardware. Core keywords, networks, analysis, routing, mobile, time. These are general words, so these are all treated as a poor keyword. Then which one is the better keywords for this title? Performance analysis, mobile networks, routing protocol, ODV protocol, DSR protocol. This is the important keywords, better keywords for this title. Okay, based on your title, you have to produce the keywords. Then how to write the introduction about in your research article. Okay, introduction must give the background information about your research topic. Your background information, what background information you want to inform in your research article must be entered in the introduction part. Okay, while writing the background, make sure your citations are, you can include your citations in the introduction itself. If you use the citations and your experimental results, how you are going to explain, how you are going to contact, how you are going to carry out your research, everything is explained by means of using a well-balanced sentences, well-balanced questions. Your hypothesis should be explained, your data set should be explained, your content may be explained. What are the things you are informed to the people? So everything should be relevant and current information should be discussed. Everything is possible to give in the introduction part. Okay. How we can be able to write the introduction part? Okay. There are 3 parts in the introduction. The first part is, it provides the background and motivation of your research topic, which also includes a review of current literature on the topic. Okay, your background information about your particular domain oriented information is explained in a paragraph. Simply, if you want one paragraph about your general topic, one paragraph about your particular topic, one paragraph about your data set, one paragraph about your methods, one paragraph about your results, one paragraph about your conclusion. Okay, what you want to produce, what you want to discuss, finally these things are discussed. Okay, now this is explained. Okay, so the scope, focus, purpose, finally what you want to conclude, everything is discussed. These things are exactly carried out. So in paragraph method, you got to explain your, you got to prepare your report or thesis, or prepare your manuscript in the introduction part. By using sentences method, you got to prepare your manuscript in abstract. In the abstract, use one or two sentences. In the introduction, use one or two paragraphs. Method, data set, and general topic, specific topic, results, and the conclusion. These things are explained. Okay. So one third of your one third or two third rule is actually from the reviewer's perspective. One third, two third rule. So one third of your research article must have must be available in the introduction part. So one third time to read your introduction and make a decision. If some people's, some reviewers are not clear about your abstract, clear about your research contribution in the abstract, definitely they must read out your introduction. After reading your introduction, if they are satisfied, then the results and other topics are not read out by the reviewers. So a good introduction with a good motivation is half of your success. So if you enter a good introduction, if you clearly state your introduction part, clearly writing your introduction part, it should give you a success, 50% of your success in your writing, in order to prepare your a successful creation of the research article. So what should cover in the introduction part? Research problem, motivation of research and the research problem, claim of your research contribution, summary of your evidence to support your claim. Claim means hypothesis. Results, claim means results. Hypothesis oriented result is called as claim. Okay, summary of your evidence, significance of your contribution, outline of the rest of the paper. Finally, at the end of the introduction, you have to write the organization of the paper. So second section going to what, third section going to what, and go to like that. Then now we are entering into the methods and materials. Materials and the methods. This section provides the reader with all the details of how you conducted your study, how you conducted your research, how you conducted your research. So the methods and the material section must have subheadings. The subheadings are separated by different, by your own way. You must use past tense, not present tense and future tense. You have to describe the new methods. You can include the new methods, the hybrid methods. The new methods are designed by yourself. Only the new method, using your new method, only you can produce some research article. Don't, it is not necessary to use the existing methods. Only simple new method is enough. Okay, only the simple new method is available in your research article, also accepted by many people in the world. Okay, one point. Another point, you simply cite the reference where the readers can find more details. Suppose if you want to refer some people's your papers, the citing methodology is clearly explained. So, okay, this is the another point. Then state all statistical tests and parameters in your materials and methods section. Therefore, this section describes what you did, how you did it, what is the strategies that you are used in order to do complete your research, which gives algorithms, sample conclusions, diagrams, circuits, descriptions of equipment. Everything should be clearly explained, not the results. You note that there is no results and discussion carried out in this section. Only the methods, circuits, diagrams, calculations. How you want to calculate, what formula you used for calculation purpose, the formula is given in the methods and the materials section. So the methods section of your research paper provides the information by which the study's validity is judged. Your validity of your study is judged based on this research and methods section. Okay, therefore it requires a clear and a precise description of how an experiment was done by you, and what is the relationship between why specific experimental procedures are chosen by you, what are the experimental approaches are actually chosen by you. These things are clearly stated. Then the section must contain about description about data. I already informed you. Description about the data, description about the data set, description about the data collection, questionnaires, definition or formula, methods and algorithms, the steps of proposed method, hybrid method. If you want to combine two algorithms in a single algorithm, you have to explain by using your own words. Okay. So now we are entering into the not fully discussed how to write a thesis article, but up to starting from the title to methods and the materials section, which is the required format for writing a proposal. The above all include to write a project proposal, whether it is a UGC project proposal or CSIR project proposal, PFMS, if you want to get another funding agencies in your university-oriented funding agencies or scientific-oriented funding agencies. Many funding agencies are available throughout the world. Many of you are not known very well. Else we are having funding agencies in order to produce our results. But there is a procedure available. Elsewhere journals are having funding agencies. But before starting your research, you have to apply the funding. You have to explain by means of starting from the title to up to methods and materials. You have to discuss the write about your project. What is your project? Everything is discussed. That is the method for writing the proposal, funding proposal. Okay. Also, which includes the funding, the special kinds like how you want to design, who is the beneficiary of your project, what is the designing concept of your project, who is going to get a benefit after completion of your project, then how much duration you want to complete your project. The duration must be as per the UGC norms, 4 years or 3 years or 5 years, like go that. So the completion of the project is very, very important. Suppose after getting the fund from the UGC or any other kind of funding agencies, if it is not possible to complete before the stipulated time, then they will never accept you. You have to submit all your fund to the people. Also, your results produced in your project must be accepted by the funding agencies. These things are the main concept of the proposal writing about getting the fund from the various sources. Okay. Now next, how we can discuss about the results. The results section contain your summaries, your results. It is very important part of your paper, which describes the observations, whatever your observed results, your obtained results by means of your investigation, by means of your findings, new kinds, new information should be visualized. The results should be in three methods. Descriptive text format. The results should be explained by means of using text. Providing numerical data in tables. Providing pictorial representation by means of visualization techniques. The observations, the table entries are visualized by means of graphs and figures. These three are very, very important. Suppose if you use graphs and figures and tables, the tables, graphs and figures must included the text. In between text alone, the figures and the graphs are actually available. So what is the method of writing the results? Table heading. The table heading must be available in top of the table. Many people are given table caption. Table caption or table heading, both are same. Okay, figure caption or figure heading. The table heading must be above the table. The figure heading must be below the figure. So this is the concept. Many people are not known very well how to prepare the standard format. Your text covers both the table and the figure. That is important. Before and after your figure and the table must one paragraph text oriented information available entered into your thesis, as well as into your research article. That is the main point. Okay. Now we are entering into how to prepare the discussion part. This section presents your research findings and your analysis of those findings. You have to analyze it, in-depth analysis. In the discussion part, what is the limitation of your data set? What is the limitation of your algorithmic approach? What is the limitation of your research finding? What is the limitation of, what is the maximum limit? What is the minimum limit? How, which is used? What is the main condition, hypothesis which are activated by means of your data set, by means of your algorithm, by means of your approach, whether your approach is fit for using the data set, whether your approach is fit for using the algorithm, or your approach is exactly fit for both data set and algorithm, everything is discussed in this method. Okay. Therefore, this section answers these questions. Why do you care about the problem and the results? What is the reason you want to care about it? Then what problem you are trying to solve? Why you are trying to solve? What kind of problem you are trying to solve? How did you go about solving or making progress on the problem? Okay. How you can make changes or progress? How you can solve the problem, everything. So limitations of your chosen data, that are already informed. How much data useful after the processing? Whether the full data are replaced or part of the data are replaced, only part is taken or full data are taken. What is your answer? So what are the implications of your research question, answer? These things are discussed. So the discussion part must include tables, chart, diagrams, graphs. All these must be explained theoretically and suggest merits and demerits. Merit, by means of some merits and demerits, visualization techniques, you can explain this part. Conclusions. Not for this session conclusion. This is the conclusion about writing, how to write conclusion in the research article. The conclusion is a summary of the research and the results of the experiment. So the summary of the research must be explained by using your own words, which shows your entire research contribution. The conclusion must include your research contribution elaborately, particularly, definitely in a new method by using your own approach. So to make a statement whether your data supported for your hypothesis or not, whether your data supported part of your hypothesis or in the entire article, whether you may also have data that did not support, why and what purpose the data are not support, what purpose the method is not support, everything is provided. Also, you have to provide the future work of your research work. Okay. Now, the next point is quoting references. The references section play a very vital role. Okay, so it is an important to properly and appropriately cite references. Definitely use references. Most of my research scholars using Mendeley Reference Manager. You must use Mendeley Reference Manager in order to cite your references or quote your references in your text. There is no error. It's a little bit of error not identify in your research article. Your thesis also. So use Mendeley Reference Manager or RefWork or EndNote. There are various reference managers are available in order to put your prepare your. So references, quoting references are done by using the three. MLA format, APA format, and CMS format. Each, what is the three kinds of format you are used? MLA format. Difference is year is after the, that is at the end year, before the title of the paper, year. Here, within quotation mark, and yet at the end of the year, this should be available. Suppose in order to find out, to find your site, your papers. If you go to the https://scholar.google.com, definitely there may be a format available in order to produce the title, in order to produce the citations. What are the different kind of citations? Not only this kind of citations, formats are available, other kinds of format are available. Okay. Next, we enter into key points to your manuscript preparation. After the summary, the advanced knowledge about your research field you require. Your ideas, make them accessible to others, easily understand by others, your article. Your article must be easily accessible, easily identified, easily understood by others. So the two key components in your research paper, an explicit claim on your contribution on your research problem. An explicit claim, a research oriented, important claim, important result must be produced by yourself. So in order to produce that result, you have to give a evidence, support. These things are very, very important. Therefore, your contribution can possibly be a contradiction of your hypothesis. Sometimes your hypothesis cannot accept it. It's not a fit for doing the data set. That also your research. Hypothesis sometimes is not fit for using the data, is not fit for using the algorithm. Why your method is not suitable for first chosen hypothesis based on the data set, that is also explained, that is also valid research-oriented contribution in the research topic. So your technique solves a problem for the first time. You are solving the first person, you are the person first time you are solving the problem. Okay. So you should avoid claiming too many dimensions. You cannot take more dimensions, no more parameters. Two or three algorithms, okay. 5 or 10 algorithms is not okay. 1 or 2 data set, it is okay. More than 5, 10 data set is not okay. So short your dimensions, short your parameters. Based on the parameters, your research must be clear. Okay. So you have to do, who is your enemy? We have to understand who is your enemy. Like me, the reviewers are, editorial board members are your enemy. So you have to cite their paper in your research article. They should identify, easily accept your articles. So whoever the editorial board member or reviewer available in a particular journal, include their name in your research article, include their article in your research article, your research paper must be easily accepted. All the experiments which are produced in your experimental, which are carried out in your research, must be conclusive, consistent. Okay, then only it is accepted. A good introduction with the already half of your success. Reading and citing relevant papers are from premier forum must. Okay, provide point by point statement of changes. How to write a top quality paper next. We know that very well, UCI machine learning repository. If I want to take if you want to discuss about database repositories, I am already posted YouTube channel webinars in my YouTube channel in the YouTube browser. If you type Dr. T. Velmurugan, you can find out searching databases for research. Like there is a discussed more databases, more than 50 databases, which are utilized nowadays for research purposes. Searching data sets for research. You have to read out that webinar and the YouTube link. Okay. using a highly appreciated, worldwide accepted data, download the paper. You can download the data set. You can download the paper. Get the unsolved problem. Produce the empirical results and give the results. Discuss your research article. Okay. Formatting your research article is very, very important. Effectively and efficiently. Known very well. Just wait. Internet connection have some disturbance. Okay, so formatting your research manuscript is very, very important. Based on the journal requirements, you have to format your research article. Initially, if you want to, first you have to understand, identify what journal you want to publish your article. Based on the journal format, you have to prepare your article. That is important. Okay, so this will speed up your entire article. That is, the reviewers are accepting easily. Whether if your research article prepared by you,
Dear participants, kindly bear with the technical glitch on the resource person's side. He will join us soon. Dear participants, due to technical glitch, we will connect to you shortly. Kindly bear with the Dear participants, if you have any queries, you can kindly post your questions in the chat box. The resource person will attend all your questions at the end of the session. dear participants, the feedback link will be posted at the end of the session. Kindly wait for the session to end. Get over. Dear participants, due to the technical glitch, we are not able to contact the resource person. We are sorry for the inconvenience. The resource person will join us soon.
ஓகேங்க சார், நீங்க ஓகேங்க சார், யூ கேன் ஸ்டார்ட்ங்க சார். தீபா?
எஸ் மேம்.
சார் உள்ள ஜாயின் ஆயிட்டார்மா? ஐ வில் ஸ்டார்ட் நவ்.
ஓகே மேம். ஓகே மேம்.
I'm sharing the PPT. Hello, sir. Sir, Velmurugan, sir. Hello. Sir, Velmurugan, sir. சார் பிடி சார், சார் பிடி சார்,
மேடம் சொல்லுங்க
சார். சார் டி வேல்முருகன்ங்கற நேம்ல அவரோட மொபைல்ல இருக்காருங்க சார், அவர் கொஞ்சம் கோஹோஸ்ட் பண்ண முடியுமா சார்?
நான் பண்ணிறேன் மேடம். ஓகே
சார்.
ஒருவேளை ஒன்னு பண்ணிட்டேன் மேடம், இன்னும் ரெண்டு பேர்ல இருக்காரா?
ஆமாங்க சார், அவருது நெட்வொர்க் கட் ஆயிடுச்சு. டி வேல்முருகன் இருக்கார் பாருங்க சார்.
அது கோஹோஸ்ட் கொடுத்தாச்சே.
இன்னொன்னு இருக்கு பாருங்க சார்.
ஒன்னு தான இருக்கு மேடம், வேலுங்கிற பேர்ல ஒண்ணுதான் இருக்கு மேடம். வேல்முருகன் பேருங்கிற ஒண்ணுதான் இருக்கு மேடம்.
ஒண்ணுதான் இருக்காங்க சார்.
ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேர் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க மேடம்.
சார் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேர் நான் தான் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கேன்.
நான் வேல்முருகன் சார்.
இல்ல இல்ல. இப்ப பண்றீங்களா? ஓகே. ஓகே.
சார் தான் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க. வேல்முருகன் சார் தான் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேர்.
ஓகே. இப்ப பண்ணல. பண்ணிட்டு இருந்த இதுக்கு முன்னாடி இப்ப அவர் பண்றாரு, ஸ்டாப் பண்ணிட்டு. ஓகே சார். ஓகே சார். थैंक यू.
Now my screen said hello.
Yes sir, we are able to see your screen sir.
Yeah, now sir, audio?
Audio is okay.
Yes sir, we are able to hear you sir.
Okay, I will continue, no problem.
Yes sir. Yes
sir. Okay. Yeah, video varla madam.
Video not
sir, pardon sir.
Video open panna illaya car oda video
sir, oda photo mattum theriyudha. நெட்வொர்க் இஷ்யூ உள்ளதுங்க சார்.
ஓகே ஓகே.
Can I continue now?
Yes, sir. You can continue, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Thank you. Now, the next, how we can start your research work? How you start your research? First, you got to decide your guide. You got to choose your guide. After choosing your guide, only you have to do your research work. Otherwise, your guide is not suitable for your ideas or for your topic, for your subject. You will never get the degree. Next point is select your major subject. You have to select your major subject. Your major subject should be a very, very important, because you must have some idea about your major subject as well as your guide having some idea about your major subject. Then select the specific topic. We have to select the specific topic. Okay, the specific topic must be important. In both of you, your specific topic must be known by yourself as well as your guide. Then collect the data set after choosing the select your specific particular topic. Collect the data set. So the data set must be suitable for doing your research work is important. Okay. Now next, do literature survey after collecting your data set. After collecting your data set, you have to do your research work. Literature survey. So based on what are the background information you want to produce in your research article, research thesis, everything is discussed by means of literature survey. Then apply methods. You got to apply the methods. After applying the methods, then it should be identified very easily what methods are used by you, what methods are not used by you. Everything is discussed here. Okay. Then publish your papers after applying your methods in the data set. After producing the results, you have to split the entire research work into three or four papers and publish papers. Then write rough thesis. Before writing the rough thesis, you don't submit your synopsis. That is my advice. My advice is to submit your research rough thesis. That is, submit your synopsis after writing the rough thesis. Then submit the synopsis. After writing the rough thesis, you have to submit the synopsis. Then formulate your thesis. After submitting the synopsis, you have to formulate the thesis. Okay. So this is the important point. Then next, fine-tune your thesis. After this submission of the synopsis, formulate the thesis, you have to fine-tune. You have to get the insight, what is available, what is not available, what you want to produce, everything is discussed. Finally, you have to submit the thesis and get the degree. Okay, this is the method. This is the simple information that we want to do. Start research, not start research. What are the steps involved in order to doing your research work? Okay. Now, the definition of intellectual property. Now we are entering into the some kind of a little bit information about the intellectual property rights. What is called as intellectual property? It is a category of property that includes intangible creation of the human intellect. Intangible creation of the human intellect is actually intellectual property. So, okay, so a new information must be identified and produced for the human life beings, for the human life information, then it is called as intellectual property. There are many types of intellectual properties. Some countries recognize more than others. Okay, what are called actually intellectual properties? Copyrights, patent rights, trademarks, trade sheets. These are four kinds of intellectual properties are available nowadays. Okay, so intellectual property is the product of human intellect, including creativity of concepts, inventions, industrial models, trademarks, songs, literature, symbols, and names, brands. Everything is included in the form of the copyright, or in the form of the patents, or in the form of the trademark and trade secrets. Okay, these are the basic information about the intellectual property. Then what is called as intellectual property? Here, the intellectual property rights refers to the general term for the assignment of your property rights through patents or copyrights or trademarks. The very famous types of intellectual property is the patent, copyright, and trademarks. For all these three kinds, how the right is given to an individual person, the investigator, the main investigator. The only one person is the main investigator, or a group of people, so we can include. Yeah. For example, that patent rights, if you want to get a patent right for your article, for your thesis, for your invention, you can include more than one people or a single people, the pad and rate you can get. So based on the your innovative idea about your research contribution, innovative idea about your research information, then only it is possible to get the intellectual property rights. So the intellectual property rights do not differ from other priority rights, property rights. So whatever the property rights you got, be using any kind of intellectual property right offices, they are also considered as a intellectual property rights. Okay, therefore the entitled, those who are having the intellectual property rights, which are entitled her or him to prevent others from using, dealing and tampering with his or with her product without prior knowledge about from him. So if you want to use the others intellectual properties, we have to get the permission from the owner. So this is the format. For that purpose alone, this intellectual property are actually created. What is the simple for the, based on your mind-oriented information, based on your information, actually which are produced using your mind is trademarks, rights, and copyrights, and intellectual properties. Properties, trademarks, and copyrights are the main concept of the intellectual properties. Okay, what is the protection of IPR? How we can protect the IPR? Which IPR allows the inventor, innovator, investigator, or the brand owner, patent holder, by means of academicians, we have patent rights. The patent holder having patent holder or copyright holder. So in order to get the benefit of their product, their innovative informations, intellectual right properties are protected. In order to protect, so your intellectual property, your properties are protected from others. In order to secure your product, in order to get the benefit of your product, your rights are exactly utilized. So such rights are set out in the International Declaration of Human Rights. In the International Declaration forms, internationally your format is accepted. Internationally, if anybody want to use your product, they have to get the permission from you. Then only it is possible to use your product by others. This is the concept. Then how they utilize, the international peoples are utilize your products using a key. The key is available with you only. So using a copyright key or patent right key, so you must publish your property rights. Okay, everything is carried out by yourself. Everything is carried out by means of your knowledge. Your knowledge only, they are utilizing. Okay, what is the IPR? What is the IPR? What are the uses of the IPR? Trade secret, trademark, trade name, patent, industrial design and models are having IPR, and geographical indications and unfair competitions, related rights and copyrights. Integrated circuits are having nowadays 64, AMD 64-bit processor having an IPR right nowadays. Okay, what is called as trademark? It's a sign that utilizes the goods or services of a given enterprise, which display and distinguishes them from those of competitors. Okay, to fall under law protection, a trademark must be distinctive. By means of a law protection, your trademark must be distinctive, differ from other people's. It should not have deceptive and illegal and immoral the use of the others. Your product must be utilized by your knowledge only. What is the duration of the trademark? 10 years. After 10 years, you get to renew it, the trademarks by the owners. This is the point. So the notation R is used for denoting the trademark. Okay. Then what are the trademarks are available throughout the world? Well, there are various trademarks are available. So what are the essential features of a trademark? It must be a mark, a brand, a heading, a name, a label, a signature, or numerical shape of goods. Sometimes we know that very well, Talapakati Hotel having trade name, trademark. They have some, that is like in head, above the head, some Talapa are used by special kind of some peoples. They got the trademark in order to use their brands, their names, their figures, their informations. So this is the best example for trademark. Okay. Now what trademark are not, which are not actually a trademark, not registrable. Okay. So this the trademark which comprises any matter like which is had to the humans, religious, are not considered as a trademark. We cannot able to get the trademark for which affect the heart of any humans, any religious, any peoples, any caste and everything is not possible to get trademark. So which make and comprises of scandalous or obscene matter. So only some obscene matters are not able to get information. So there are some act are available. Emblems and the name act is available, at least for the purpose of getting the trademark. Okay. What is the best example for geographical indication? Now, we know that very well, Kanjivaram silk, Tirunelveli halwa, Darjeeling tea, Mysore silk are the best examples of geographical indication oriented symbols. That is patents, trademark, and geographical indication are also considered as a trademark. Okay, there are various kinds of trademark nowadays available. Tivoliputur, Palkova is also having a trademark. Okay, one of the trademark information, the trademark actually the geographical informations are applied for a 10 years period. After 10 years, we have to renovate and use it in future. This is the main concept. So geographical indications are more region-wise, area-wise, city-wise, and other informations are actually carried out. Okay. Now, what are the other kinds of trademarks? Industrial designs and models are treated as a trademarks, a special kind of trademarks. The industrial design and models are given rights for 10 years. After the 10 years, they can expand for 5 years. And after the, every 5 years, they have to renew it. So, this is the industry. So, what are the different kinds of industrial model and design? Most of the trademark-oriented industrial design and models are built by using this symbol. Okay, this symbol is used for designing the industrial design and models. Now we are entering into the patent. What is called as a patent? It is an exclusive right granted by law, by means of law protection, to an inventor, to an investigator, or an assignee to prevent others from commercially benefiting from her patented invention without permission for a limited period, for a particular period. Your product should be, the inventor's product should be used by permission only. So this is called as a patent. Suppose you have a patent right in a particular so-and-so topic, theoretical oriented information. If you want to include your theoretical concept in their area, in their article, in their usage, in their day-to-day life, they have to get the permission from you. That is the main concept of the patent. What is the duration of patent? 20 years from the date of the filing. So what are the various patent right offices are available? Chennai, Mumbai, New Delhi, and Kolkata. In India, there are more four places the patent right offices are available. Okay, which are all under the control of the central government. Most of the government-oriented patent rights offices are available. Okay, what is the symbol for patent right? This is the symbol for the patent right. Okay, what is patentable? A product, a gadget for producing the product, a process, a method. A process means a method, a pattern is also called as a patentable. So a composition of matter, the composition of matter, the composition of so-and-so technique is also considered as a patentable. But computer programs are not able to get patents. Medical and surgical treatments, mathematical methods, business methods, some of the authentic creation of arts, figures, the everything, animals, plants, these are all not able to get patentable. Okay. Now, what is the basic requirement for patentability? Your product must be novel. Your product must be very, very novel. So, novelty oriented, utility oriented. Your product must be available very effectively and efficiently. The usefulness of your idea. Okay, just a wait. Hello. Wait, I'm in my webinar. Okay, non-obvious, the information should be, patentable information should be an obvious one. It's just not non-obvious. Then there must be a written disclosure available in order to get a use your patentable, your patents information. What are the patents and everything is available. So trade name and trade secrets are some other kind of IPR. Protections. Trade name, a business name is a name that uniquely distinguishes a business. That is Amazon, Flipkart. Flipkart is the name, company name, they use only the for their products like the trade names are utilized, the trade secrets. Some of the trade secrets are filed and stored in a particular storage place. By using some secret information, secret key, we can use digitally. The secret key are mostly available nowadays, very effectively handled. Stem cell therapy, stem cell informations are nowadays stored in by means of the trade secret using methodologies. Okay. Then what is called as a copyright for any kind of product, artistic work, writings, musicals, and fine arts, paintings and sculptures, we require copyright. So in order to use that, if you want to use that figures and other quoted informations that they are already having copyright, we have get permission from that. Okay, so what is the duration of a copyright? So duration of the copyright is 60 years, mostly. The films and the photographs are having copyright for 60 years. After 60 years, they will the broadcasting informations are 25 years copyright we can able to get. So this there are various categories of getting copyright for any kind of information. So for music only 25 years, or for some kind of music only 40 years, like we can get the copyright. Okay. Now what is the symbol for copyright? This is the symbol for the copyright. Then what is actually intellectual property? Offices are available. So suppose if you click this link, there are, you can find out worldwide then IPR offices available in the world. Okay. Now what is IPR? It is a category of property that includes intangible creations of human intellect and primarily encompasses copyrights, patents and trademarks. In order to get copyrights, patents and trademarks, we utilize this IPR concept. That is IPR, intellectual property rights we can get. Okay. Also it includes other types of rights, such as trade secrets, trade names, publicity of rights, moral rights, right against unfair competition, everything is carried out. So the main purpose of IPR law is due to encourage the creation of large variety of intellectual goods. For the large variety of intellectual goods, they use the IPR law in order to produce the rights. Okay. Now we are entering into the journal publications. What are the requirements for journal publication? What we require? So what is the purpose of using the journal publication? What is the use of the indexing and abstracting services? What is Scopus and Web of Science? And what is Scopus Journals and Web of Science? Journals we discuss in this. What we require primarily in a particular journal? A journal must have a ISSN number. A journal must have a ISSN number. Without ISSN number, a journal must not identify. So at least the minimum requirement for a journal is ISSN number. How to verify the ISSN number? There is a method available in order to identify the ISSN number. Okay. The next we want to understand whether the journal having the print line, print version or online version only, or both. So peer reviewed journal or not. The number of issues per year is identified. Whether it is a paid journal or unpaid journal. Then what is the review period? How we can identify the review period? You have to go through a particular journal site and download a journal article in that journal. In that particular journal article, they produced when they accept, then when they get the review, when they taken for review, and when they accept for publication, the period between the acceptance and the review period, that is manuscript received and acceptance for publication, is the review period. Then what is the, these things are, you can understand easily by referring the websites of the each and every journals. Okay. Now, what are the indexing services at least we require for any kind of journals? Google Scholar, DOI, Scopus, and SCI, DOEJ. At least Google Scholar citations. Some kind of, apart from this Google Scholar indexing service, DOI, digital object identifier. When a journal having digital object identifier, then it must be Archive indexing database. Then only DOI number is allotted for kind of the journals. Then Scopus database, Scopus journal, SCI journal, Science Citation Index, AHCI, DOIJ means Directory of Open Access Journals. These things are discussed. Okay. What is the use of the abstracting and indexing services which are utilized exactly by means of the journal articles. Okay. Now, abstracting services are given fast searching capabilities. For the document searching purpose, the indexing services are mostly placed. So, what are the indexing services are available in front of the journal or in end of the journal, end of the book or in the front of the book? What are the indexing services? What is the ISSN number? What is the ISBN number? What kind of indexing and abstracting services are carried out? Everything is displayed. What are the very famous indexing services? Scopus is very famous indexing services. Indian Citation Index also having some peer-reviewed journal published in this. Now, but apart from these two, our UGC requirement is a Scopus indexed journals. But Web of Science and Web of Knowledge journals are what? The Web of Science and journals are playing very vital role in the field of the research communities. Okay. Now, what are the very famous indexing and abstracting databases are available? SCI, SCIE, SSCI, AHCI, also Scopus, CiteSeerX, Google Scholar, these are some kind of indexing services are available. Okay, what is the most significant UGC recommended SCI and Scopus journals? In 2007 itself, they published 2009 itself in Times of India paper article, there must be article available. The need of the Scopus indexed journals about which is referred by the identified by the UGC guidelines, actually identified. Okay, now what is the requirement UGC required journal publication? If you click this link, you can get easily the UGC journal list. Okay, what is Scopus? Scopus is a very large database which is available in the universally in the world nowadays. Universally, which one is the large database? Very high volume of information are available, only the data for Scopus database. Scopus database is actually maintained by Elsevier. Elsevier company, you know very well what is the use of Elsevier. In Scopus database is produced in the year 2004 by the Elsevier company. So how many titles, how many journals are available? 40,386 titles are available, 24,000 active titles and inactive titles are also available. Suppose if you want to get a Scopus database, if you click this one, scopus.com, you can easily download the Scopus databases. Okay, so suppose if you want to explore and going into the website, I will explain, but time is very less than we can go. You can go to the title. You can easily download the Scopus title, which are available recently published in June. This information are given June 2020 Scopus database files. 40,386 titles are available. Okay. if you want to download the Scopus database file, you can refer my YouTube channel also, in which there are various lot of articles are available. Most of the articles are research oriented articles, in which how to get the Scopus database, how to convert the Scopus Scopus database to Scopus informations to RCID, everything is displayed in this. Okay, what are the various kinds of informations available in the Scopus? 70 million items are available. So 5,000 publishers, more than 5,000 publishers are available. Okay, this is the information actually provided in the Scopus. Then what is Web of Science? So Web of Science is actually, it is a citation indexing service, which is actually created by the Clarivate Analytics. The Clarivate Analytics company is the owner of the, Clarivate Analytics is the company. This company is the owner of this Web of Science. Previously, the Web of Science is called as Web of Knowledge. Now, previously, the Clarivate Analytics company is called as Thomson Reuters company. Okay, so you can easily find out many journals which are indexing oriented. What are the WS category of journals? There are four categories of journals are available. All these journals are easily downloaded by using this Clarivate Analytics. How we can find out the Web of Science category of journals? Simply you can download. In this branch Web of Science, you can go to the Web of Science here, in which resources are available. Here you can find out the downloads. Here you can use master journal list. In the master journal list, you can find out easily where the downloads are available. Using the downloads section, you can download the each and every article which are available in the master's journal list. Okay. Now we continue. Our screen. Now this is the various categories: arts and humanities citation index AICTI, science citation index expanded, which is the expansion of the SCI journals, so science citation index also. SSCI now. Last year, 2 years before only, emerging sources citation index is produced in the Clarivative Analytics. Whenever they change their name into Clarivative Analytics, they propose a emerging sources citation index. The first citation index, journal citation report, is not produced up to this date because in order to produce the impact factor of a particular journal, we have to monitor the journal at least for 3 years. So impact factor is calculated for this 2019, not for the 2020. So impact factor is calculated for 2019 for a particular journal. For particular journal only, the impact factor is actually calculated. How the impact factor of the journal calculated for the year 2019, the number of articles which are published during the 2017 and 2018, the number of papers published in a particular journal article is the denominator of the article, for example 500, and then these two papers are published in the year 2018 are numerator of the journal impact factor. So numerator divided by the number of citations which are published during the year 2017 and 2018 are available in numerator. Then denominator, the total number of papers which are published in 2017 and 2018 is. So only 5 articles are referred by other people which are in the year 2018. But the total number of papers which are published in the journal is 500. 5 divided by 500 is the impact factor for a particular journal. Like they can calculate. Okay. Therefore, you have to remember that points. Timely, you have to do your research. Suppose if after registering your PhD, if you take more time, then definitely which never improve your style. It never create your impact. Okay, so you have to do timely your research work. For that, you have to use your manpower. Your enthusiasm is very, very important. Your enthusiasm, your approach, your active participation in doing research is very, very important. After these two are exactly carried out by you, then writing thesis, you have to write the thesis. Then using your presentation style, prepare your manuscript. Finally, what you get, your gained knowledge. Your knowledge should be gained. It is very important. But research differs. Research always differs. One person to another person in the same field, in the same data set, in the same algorithms. For using a particular data set, particular algorithm, the research differs from one person to another person. Okay. So do research with perseverance. All the best. Thank you. If you have any questions, you can ask me now. Otherwise, thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your detailed explanation on writing a research paper, tips to make an article publishable, about IPR, Web of Science, citation index, and a lot more. Our day has become really meaningful listening to you, sir. Now, the session is open for discussion. Participants can raise your queries in the chat box and a resource person will attend to.
Sir, Velmurugan sir.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, I'm Gayatri. Wonderful session.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
very practical implementations were explained.
Sorry for my inconvenience, because every day at 11:30 the net will disturb me.
It happens, sir. It happens. No problem. But anyhow, the session was very wonderful and very, very informative and valuable session. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Okay. If you have any questions, you can ask. No problem.
Participants, you can raise your queries in the chat box.
I think no questions, ma'am. Okay.
Dear participants, you can raise your queries in the chat box. Actually, sir, your explanation was very detailed and it was crystal clear.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you very much. I am not switch on my camera. The second time. That's why my video is not displayed. Okay, thank you. No problem.
Sir, we are able to see you, sir.
Now I have opened. Now my
yes,
camera
okay.
is open. Okay.
Okay,
sir. Thank you. Okay, ma'am, if there is no question, means you can do what of thanks.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thanks is a small word, but has lots of meaning. Now, I welcome Dr. Jayanti ma'am to propose vote of thanks.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. On behalf of our management and funding development cell, I am indeed a great honor and privilege to extend the vote of thanks. Today, I took this opportunity to put all my gratitude into words. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. Next, I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to our honorable correspondent, sir, Thiru K. Palanisamy avargal, for providing us a great opportunity to organize a thought-provoking webinar on effective writing strategies of academic articles for premier journals. Next, I wish to express my sincere thanks to our beloved principal, Dr. N. Raman, sir, who always provide us constant support and encouragement. In simple words, without his guidance and support, reaping the fruit is impossible for us. Thank you, sir, for your round-the-clock support to us. It's my duty to convey my sincere and heartfelt thanks to our today's chief guest, Dr. T. Velmurugan, sir, Associate Professor and Head of the Department of D.G. Vaishnav College, Chennai, for taking his precious time out and spend with us to share valuable ideas on writing research articles. His ideas helps us to step into the research platform with clear contest. Thanks a lot for sharing most valuable information with us, sir.
Next, I would like to thank
our funding development cell coordinator, Dr. J. Gayatri Devi, Associate Professor of Computer Science Department, PG, for her untiring support and directions to make this event a memorable one. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to express my thanks to all funding development cell associate members for their kind coordination and cooperation to make this event a great grand success. Thank you, one and all. I also wish to thank all the head of the departments and other teaching faculties who graced us with your presence and kind cooperation. Thank you, one and all. It's my duty to thank our digital partner and backbone supporter, Dr. A. Shankar, sir, physical director, Kongo Arts and Science College, for giving us a wide technical support to organize this inaugural function with great success. The day starts with green, ends with evergreen, only on behalf of you, sir. Thank you so much. Last but not least, I also wish to thank research scholars who participated and benefited in this webinar. Thank you, one and all. Once again, I thank you all.
Thank you all. Thank you, participants. Sir, Deepa? Deepa? Deepa?
Thank you, ma'am. Dear participants, thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, I can hear you, ma'am.
Yes, we hear you. Yeah,
hello.
Yes, Deepa, we hear you.
Thank you, ma'am. Any point that is provided in the chat box, ma'am, shall we end it?
Yes.
So with this, we come to the program. One for your kind cooperation and action. Stay healthy and stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Sir, PD sir, thank you, sir. Hello.
Wind up the session, sir. Is not there, ma'am.
Yes, we can wind up the session, sir. PD sir.
Oh. Ma'am, PD sir is not there.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, Deepa, we can wind up the session, sir. Thank you, sir. Well done, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Sir. Thank you for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am, and I'm closing the session.
Okay. Thank you, Deepa.